Health Connection, medical assistance for all.
Hi, this is Dr. Rakesh Jain. I'm a senior consultant pediatric neurologist at Fortis Memorial Research Institute, Gurgaon. I'm making these video clips in association with Health Connection for public awareness. Today I'm going to talk about a clumsy child. I get a lot of queries from parents regarding my child is not able to do multitasking. He is not able to finish the task. He's all over the places. He doesn't know how to wear the clothes. Although he's 5 years old, he's not able to wear his clothes. He doesn't do how to do shoelaces, so on and so forth. Child loses pencil, sharpeners, lots of stationery in the school. Every day we have to buy new things. So these are quite a lot of problems, including he's running in a different manner. He looks very awkward when he runs as compared to his peers. He is not able to chase the ball in a coordinated manner. He is not able to catch a ball when he's playing cricket. Or he's struggling to play badminton or table tennis. Lots of things that comes under the category of clumsy child. So what is clumsy child? It looks very, very odd to hear like that, clumsy child. But yes, this is a medical term. And you will be surprised to know that 5 to 10% of children in a class of, let's say, 100 would have a problem of clumsiness, or in a medical terminology we call it dyspraxia or developmental coordination disorders. And these children, if they are not looked at in time properly and early interventions not started, then they could have problem with the low self-esteem, low academic score, a bit poor in sports, and ultimately they can lead on to some psychiatric and behavioral problems. So it is extremely important to identify those so-called clumsy or dyspraxia children and do the early intervention accordingly. So what we can do about these children? Usually before 5 years of age, children are not coordinated properly, so we give them benefit of doubt. So we don't diagnose them as a clumsy child. We just try to train them so that they can be better organized person when they grow up, how to finish the homework, how to be good at sports, how to wait for their turns, and what best we can do. But after 5 years of age, if they are lagging behind their peers in all those kind of activities, then we must think about dyspraxia, dyslexia, even the part of the same term, where child is not able to write the letters in a proper manner. For example, if you ask them to write D, they might write in D, you know, the convexity of D in the opposite direction. They might continue to wear wrong footwears. The right foot footwears, they go into the left. They don't have any understanding of that, and other person can make out very easily, but it becomes very difficult for them to understand this is my left footwear, this is my right footwear. So intervention at early stage would definitely help them not only to overcome these problems to a certain extent, but also to build up their self-esteem, build up their academics, and so on and so forth. You must consider going to your pediatric neurologist or developmental pediatrician, because there are some conditions, there are some problem in the connections of nerves inside the brain which can lead on to this problem. Many a times we may not find any obvious problem in the medical test, but still an experienced doctor can make out this problem. And once we start some training in terms of occupational therapy, handwriting training, some physiotherapy depending upon, you know, if it is required. These children, sometimes they do struggle in speech as well. So some speech therapy, some clinical psychology support, if put them together, they can be really helped out of the situation. And as they grow with this intervention and better understanding, these children, they tend to grow in almost normal manner, apart from few percentage of children which don't do very well when they grow up. So early intervention is the key, and we must not miss them. Thank you very much.
Special thanks to Mr. Sudhir Gopalia and the management team of Fortis Hospital in association with Health Connection.
Medical disclaimer: the information in this video is not intended or implied to be a substitute for professional medical advice, diagnosis or treatment. All content, including text, graphics, images, and information contained on or available through this video is for general information purposes only. It is not intended as medical advice, and should not be relied upon as a substitute for consultations with qualified health professionals who are familiar with your individual medical needs. The whole sole purpose of this video is to make people aware of healthcare and medical knowledge and developments. We at Health Connection specially recommend you to visit an authorized physician nearby for medical opinion, medication, treatments or procedures. For more details, kindly visit our website, www.healthconnection.in, or if you have any questions, comments or concerns, please do not hesitate to write to us at info@healthconnection.in.